Hello everyone, welcome to Shishu World. I am Priya and today I'm going to chat about something which is, I'm sure, very dear to all of us. It's the festival of lights, Diwali. Now, Diwali is coming and it is my most favorite festival of the year. But among the festivities, we often tend to forget the safety tips, you know, safety concerns during this festival. It is also one of the most polluting festivals of the year. So it's important that we take a step back and, just make sure that once we have children around us, you cannot be as carefree as earlier. So let's talk about a few things today. The first thing that I would like to talk about is crackers or fireworks. So if possible, try not to get any fireworks or get very few if you have to. I want to boycott them completely, but I know my daughter loves them. So I'll probably get one pack of sparkles and that's about it. So that she can be happy. But then we also do not pollute the environment too much. But whenever you buy any fireworks, ensure that you're buying them from a good and certified place. You know, but you don't want to end up in an accident afterwards. So that is of utmost importance. Now, whenever your children are bursting crackers, ensure that you are around or some responsible adult is around. They should never be bursting crackers on their own. Then usually when we are doing puja or we are lighting diyas, we are usually dressed up in nice finery, silks and synthetics. So when it is time to burst crackers, ensure that you and your children have changed into cotton clothes, because they are safer. They don't catch fire as fast as synthetic or silks. So that is a very important step. Also, don't wear too flowy garments when you are playing with fireworks. Change into something which is comfortable yet not too flowy and loose. Keep a bucket of water near, because even though it may not happen and it may never have happened, you never know when an accident can occur. It happened to us. My mother, she got hurt pretty badly and she was standing like very far, almost 50 meters away from where this firecracker was burst, and then this stone just came and hit her right here. Thankfully, her eye was not hurt. So let's not take a risk. Always be prepared for any eventuality. Next, we come to fire safety. Then when you're lighting diyas or candles inside your house, don't light them too near your curtains. Even though you might feel it's a little far, there might be some gust of wind, and when it catches fire, you don't know. So keep a safe distance. Keep some things handy, like emergency numbers, closest hospital, so that if you have to rush someone to the hospital, you know, you don't waste time looking for numbers and where to go and what to do, things like that. A first aid box is very, very important. Keep your basic antiseptic solutions, gauze, cottons, burn all, things like that. They should be ready and handy. Check for any inflammable material. So if you see any a two-wheeler standing where you are bursting crackers, ensure that it has been removed. Or if there is a pile of clothes or something, just be ensure that nothing of that sort is around the area where you're bursting crackers. Next is we also it's everybody gets those electrical lights to hang on their in front of their houses, and they look so beautiful. So when you're getting them, ensure that they are good quality and they should not just short and start a fire. So test them beforehand. Things like next, we come to food safety. Now, food safety is another important aspect. And Diwali is also as much about food as it is about lights and crackers and stuff. In fact, more about food and family and stuff. So, whenever you're buying sweets and dry fruits, ensure that you're buying them from a good, well-known vendor. Every year we hear news about, artificial sweets and artificial milk, because the number of dairy or the cows and buffaloes and those animals has not gone up suddenly, but the demand goes up. So to counter that, a lot of unscrupulous things happen, and there are artificial sweets which come into market, and you will not be able to tell, but they will be really bad for your health. So if possible, make at home. If it is not possible, buy from a reputed vendor, even if you have to pay a little extra. Then just go a little easy on the sweets and stuff, because even I love gorging on goodies at around this time, but then once the festival is over, you always feel, oh yeah, zyada ho gaya, let's kam khate to acha hota. So just go a little easy. But the environmental concerns, yeah, people know that Indian cities are among the most polluted in the world, and every year the pollution levels go higher around the time of Diwali, and it's because of the noise and the litter that we all make. So let us try and be a little more responsible and try to be kinder to our environment, because it's us. It's only going to affect us. It's not like you can do all that and next day you go to another world. So every year we see that the smog levels are higher, and almost for the next 15 days children have troubles of asthma and bronchitis and other breathing problems. So let us try and tone it down a bit. Next is let us be sensitive to others, and try and see if there are pets or older people or babies around, and we know that they can get disturbed by by a lot of noise or whatever festivities we indulge in. So try to have a cut off time, let's say 10 o'clock, and after that let us tone it down a bit so that other people are not disturbed. Then finally, as parents, it is our duty to raise our kids as responsible citizens and teach them about this beautiful festival, and tell them that this is more about family and festivities, and not just about making noise and bursting firecrackers. So I hope that when I meet you after Diwali, you would have had a wonderful, wonderful festival. And from me and from the Shishu World team, we wish you a very, very happy Diwali. And if you like this video, don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to the channel. We'll see you again post Diwali with another video. Bye.